of murder, greed, corruption, violence, exploitation, adultery, and treachery. All those little things we hold near and dear to our hearts. Thank you.
Thank you.
little murderer, though.
Moira?
That's not Moira shooting a boy away. Just last week, a jury thanked the man. I said, thank me.
I guess you know you're Chicago, all right. Time.
Dedicated to her dear husband.
Veronica Redding. favorite. You're the classiest dame in this whole joint. You're like family to me. Like my own. I'll do it for $50. $50 for a phone call. You must have a lot of wrong numbers, woman.
You put it. means you a lump of lead in your hand is something you really need. Help of your fellow man. Those are the kinds of love what I'm talking about. And the physical love ain't so bad.
Choice. like this. Either I get the entire 5,000, or you rot in jail before I bring you to trial.
Rot in jail? You don't mean that, do you?
I certainly do.
Look, Mr. Flynn, I'm not very good at this sort of thing. I've always had a great deal of trouble expressing myself, but can we possibly make some sort of arrangement between us? I can be an awfully good sport.
Hey, give me one thing to me. $5,000, that's all, get it?
Now, in a few minutes, we'll get on a big press conference. There's going to be a whole bunch of photographers and reporters, and that SARS sister from the Evening Star is coming.
Love him. Thank you.
foreigners. I used to date this well-to-do ugly bootlegger. He used to like to take me out and show me off. Ugly guys like to do that. What's it in the paper? Airlines out for Pelly see the chain vetoed with cute red-headed Doreen. That was me. I took it out and saved it. Now look. Tell you the truth. Not that the truth really matters, but I'm gonna tell you.
You know that I am not a jealous person. Your friend, Mama? She wanted to make some phone calls for me. You know what I told her? I don't need you. And I'm telling you the same thing. I don't need anybody. Haven't you read the papers lately? I'm a star. I'm a big star. Single.
Thanks.
Nothing personal, you understand? Nothing personal.
Oh, nothing personal. Nothing's ever personal.
The deserted bride on her wedding night, alone and shaking with fright, with her brand new hobby nowhere in sight.
I simply cannot do it.
Miss Velma Kelly.
Notice him. If someone in a movie show early fall. September. Can you count? September. So you couldn't have passed it with me. That I still wasn't a care.
Made of more than air, and all that thought you're about to
you for 10 minutes.
Don't do that again.
Okay.
I have Amos to file for divorce.
Yeah, so now what?
So now we get him on the stand and get him to admit he made a terrible mistake because he's still in love with you. And of course, you're still in love with him. And the jury will fall all over themselves to play Cupid to get you back together again. Maybe I did. Don't shut up about the dress. They care about everything you got to do when you get on the...
But we can give her another chance. And that's all for you.
All for me?
That's it.
Why, hell it is. It's me they want to see, not you.
It's my speech that brings them in. It's my speech that saves your neck.
If they can see it through all this crackling.
Roxie, it'll be all right. I've been around a long time, and believe me, you got nothing.
which you admit having had illicit relations with a deceased Fred Casely. Is this statement true or false?
I'm afraid it's true, Fred.
You're an honest girl, Roxie.
When did you first meet Fred Casely?
When he saw Amos at me out furniture. Also, he was a regular patron at the nightclub where I was a member of the chorus.
And your relationship with him? Tell the jury. When did that begin?
When I permitted him to drive me home one night.
Hey, Chickie.
Hello, Mr. Casely.
My
didn't even want my picture.
My exit music, please.
Gone. All gone.
Thank you.